Grace and peace unto you one more time this blessed Sunday morning. Hallelujah. September 25th. Hallelujah. 2016. I am Dr. Bishop Shane Paisley. And this morning I want to let you know that God loves you and he cares for you. And because he cares for you, God wants to correct you. And God wants to bring discipline in your life. This morning the word of God is coming from Matthew chapter 25. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Matthew chapter 23. Praise God. The Lord maybe want me to go to 25 too. Woe to the teachers. Oh Lord have mercy. Verse 13. And the law, my God, and Pharisees, you hypocrite. You shut the kingdom of heaven in men's faces. You yourself do not enter, nor will you let those enter who are trying to. My God, my God. Father, we just thank you for this word in Jesus' name. God is saying this morning, the word, the spirit of hypocrisy. The spirit of hypocrisy is a very strong word. And sometimes we as Christians do not want to hear the word, the spirit of hypocrisy. When we hear the word, the spirit of hypocrisy, then we tend to say someone is airing their dirty linen. Someone is trying to condemn. Someone is throwing words. Someone is doing something evil. And someone is trying to make trouble. Because the word is strong medicine. It is called the spirit of hypocrisy. Hypocrisy, and those who practice hypocrisy are hypocrites. And those who are hypocrites have hidden the truth of God, having and knowingly the truth of God, but conceal the truth because they want to gain popularity from those who are living not according to the kingdom. Now the Bible says from the day of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God suffered violence, and the violence taken by force. Now you got to understand that the kingdom of God needs to be preached. And you cannot preach the kingdom of God and do not preach repentance. Hallelujah. Back in the 90s when the Lord sent me to the Bahamas, the Lord gave me 2 Peter 3 verse 9. God is not slack concerning his promises, as some men come slackness, but is long suffering to us born, not willing that any should perish, but all should come to repentance. Now, if you do not preach the truth, those that are bound in sin cannot be delivered. Now, you cannot, hallelujah, sit around and say, don't judge them, do not talk bad about them. Now, you hypocrite, because behind their backs, you sit and gossip about the person's lifestyle. You talk about the evil that the person is doing, and in front of them, you pat them on the back and tell them, it is okay. That is the spirit of hypocrisy. The spirit of hypocrisy has invaded our lives. It has invaded our church. The spirit of hypocrisy is having the truth but hiding the truth because we become people pleaser. Hallelujah. The spirit of hypocrisy needed to eradicate it out of our lives. Hallelujah. And the spirit of hypocrisy always increase and bring forth other spirits. Hallelujah. When you are an hypocrite, my God, you become a backbiter, my God. Because now you are telling the person that they are right, hallelujah, when they are wrong. Oh Lord, hypocrite, you are telling the person that is good when it is bad. Hypocrite, you are telling the person that nothing is wrong with sin, and yet you know, according to Romans 6:23, the wages of sin is still death, and the gift of God is eternal life. Oh hypocrite, you cannot hold the truth of God from the people of God, because if they do not hear the truth, they correction. The word of God comes forth to condemn sin. Hallelujah. And sin need to be condemned. And sin needed to be judged. And I am here as a judge and the seed. And I will judge you. I will judge them. And I will judge myself. And I will leave no stone unturned, because sin is sin. Whether you try to turn it up, spin it round, or roll it, whether it's the rich man, the poor man, it is the same sin. Now, I want you to understand, speaking the word in love is to tell the person, I love you, but I hate the sin. Even the songwriter back home in Jamaica, in our church that I grew up, there was a songwriter that said, I hate the sin that makes me moan and chew me from my Savior's breast. Oh, you know, hear me, somebody. You gotta hate that sin. Sin will bring you open disgrace. Sin will bring you dishonor. Sin will bring you broken dreams and painful memories. Sin will bring you misery. Sin will bring you torment. Sin will bring you all manner of sickness and diseases. And sin will bring you unnecessary burden. So because of that, the Bible says that all have sinned. But shall we continue in sin that grace may abound? God forbid. Yes, my brother and my sisters and my friend, you may be saying, how is it Bishop Shane sitting acting as if he's righteous? The Bible says, by his stripe we were healed, and I'm healed from unrighteousness. How is he sitting acting if he is as if he is perfect? Bible said, be ye perfect, for I am perfect. How is he sitting acting as if he is holy? The Bible said, be ye holy, for I am holy. I am striving towards perfection. The reason why I'm striving towards perfection, the Bible says, lay aside every sin and weight that is well beset us. Now, if we know that every sin carries a consequence, why sit in your condition and die? It was Paul who says in this word that every time I try to do good, he will present himself. It was Paul even says that if I try to do good and I find myself doing evil, it is not I that do it no more, but sin that liveth in my mortal body. Now, my brothers and sisters, where is that judging? This is about confrontation, letting the sinners know that the wages of sin is death. Even those that are in the church, in the Christendom community, who is there and living comfortable in sin. Now, I want to take you out of your comfort zone. The reason why you must be pulled out of your comfort zone is because you are comfortable riding straight to hell. You don't hear me, somebody? And God desire that none should perish, but all should come to repentance. Now, you must understand, that if the people hear the word and they refuse to take the word, then the judgment do not rest upon my shoulder. But until then, it is my responsibility to rightly divide the word of truth. It is my responsibility to cry out and spare not. It is my responsibility to tell the people, shun the very appearance of evil. It is my responsibility to tell the entire universe that man that is born of a woman have a short time to live, and that one day we shall give account to everything that we have done in our body. It is also my responsibility to tell the world that come from amongst them, be ye separated. It is my responsibility to cry out, 2 Chronicles 7 verse 14, if my people who have called by my name should humble themselves and pray and seek my face, says the Lord of hosts, and turn from our wicked ways, then he will hear from heaven. heaven, forgive our sins, and heal our land. No, my brothers, in my closing, stay away from hypocrite people. Those that are hypocrite mean you no good. If they see you going the wrong direction, and they refuse to shine a little kindness, to show a little kindness, to shine their lights, that everyone may see. Today, I want to shine the light. And I want to say to someone, this very day, the spirit of hypocrisy is an evil spirit, and this spirit must be condemned. Stay away from the spirit of hypocrisy. Keep the dream alive.